The most important thing here is the coil. So we all know that when a coil is energised, when current starts going through the actual through the wiring, a magnetic field is being produced. Now, with lots of coils wrapped around, the small amount of current going through there, every extra turn of the coil, the magnetic field is increased. So when current goes through this coil, a large magnetic field is produced here. And what happens is this coil, this line here, this contact, this line that joins all the contacts together, what will happen is when this is energized, this will shoot over and join all the contacts together. In order to do that, obviously we need to energize the coil. So the coil on any type of starter circuit like this is known as the control circuit. And the idea of this is that only a small amount of current is going to be used within this coil to actually start a much heavier load. So a starter, a direct online starter in this case could be working a half horsepower motor, or sort of like a 300-400 watt motor. Anything up to about 4 kilowatts you can use online starters for. Depending what the motor is being used for, you can go bigger, but a general rule is up to about three, four, or five kilowatts is the most that you really want to be running with a direct online starter. And as you can see, this is single phase. Okay, so how do we energize the coil? Well, obviously this start button is the thing that we're going to have to press. So if we press the start button, I'm not going to draw on the diagram because it might, I don't want to mess it up for you. If we press this button, in fact, no, I will press it because it needs to. So if we press this button, it will, as that button is pressed, it will link across numbers 17 and 18. And as we know, number 17 is wired to number 13, which is wired to number 1 in this case, which is the permanent live supply. As soon as the start button is pressed, both 17, which is live, and 18 now also becomes live. Also, number 14 becomes live. Also, the stop button becomes live, and 95 and 96 become live, as does A1. So as soon as this is pressed, current flow will go through the stop button, through 95, 96, back out through to A1, through the coil, and back through the neutral. So suddenly you have a circuit. You have a circuit going through the coil, all the way back through the neutral, all the way through here, and the A1, the actual A1 and A2, and the coil is fully energized. Now, what would happen then is the magnetic field within here becomes so the field here becomes magnetized and will pull over this, what we would call it, an armature. It pulls it across, and then it directly contacts, it links these contacts here. And so now electricity can go all the way through the contacts, all the way through to the motor, back through here, back through there, and it all becomes energized and the motor would work. So you press the button, the coil becomes energized, this shunts across, joins all the contacts together, the motor begins to run. Now that's all okay while you've got your finger pressed on the start button, but while you're working, you don't want to stand there with your finger on the start button. This start button is a normally open button. So in its normal state, the contacts aren't joined together. Only when we press them together are both contacts joined. As soon as you take your finger off the button, spring pressure will open the the start button. So let's look what actually happens when you press this. So we press this button, 17 is live, 18 also now becomes live. In parallel with this button, with the start button, are the retaining contacts. So now, as soon as this is pressed, both the 13 and 14 become live. As soon as you open it, as soon as you take your finger off and this opens, this no longer becomes live, but 13 and 14 are live. And if you remember, 14 is connected to number 18. So now, as soon as you take your button off this, the retaining contacts are keeping all of the contacts retained. And so, whereas before, I was saying, as soon as you press this button, the electricity flow will come through here and through here and to the coil. As soon as you take your fingers off this, it no longer comes across 17 to 18, but instead it comes down through 13 to 14, all the way to 18. So 18 still remains energized, even though the start button has been depressed. I'll just go over that again. So we press this button, and 18 becomes live, and the circuit and the coil becomes live and energised, and the armature shunts across and the contacts come into play. 17, 18, the start button is in parallel with the retaining contacts, 13 and 14. So as soon as you take your finger off this, 13 and 14 remain energised through the contact. And so then the current flow now is going through here and still following the same route, keeping the coil energised. So that's really quite nice and simple. As we've said as well, the normally closed stop button is in series with the circuit, so nothing much happens here, nothing changes. As soon as you press, as soon as you depress this button, electricity is still flowing, the electron flow is still going through here, because it's coming through this way now. And then it just goes through 95 and 96 to A1, and then everything's okay. So what happens now if we press the stop button? So a normally closed contact now becomes open. And so as you can see, as soon as this becomes open, and I'll just put my finger across it there to represent the wires now aren't joined together, suddenly, no electricity, no electrons can flow through this wire and up to 95 or 96. So what happens is A1 now loses its live feed. And so current flow isn't going through the coil anymore. So the coil becomes de-energized, and under spring pressure, the contacts, the armature shunts back across, opens the contacts and stops the motor. So I'll just say that again. So the normally closed stop button is in series normally. You open it, it takes that out of the circuit, it breaks the circuit up, and that circuit breaks the coil, the electricity going through the coil, the magnetic field is broken. So under spring pressure, the armature returns back, opening all of the contacts, and the start and the motor stops. So I think that's all I need to sort of say for the control diagram explaining the single phase direct online starter. It's quite a simple circuit. Let's just ask a couple of questions as to why we use a direct online starter. Okay, so if you imagine you're in a workshop and there's a motor running around, there's a lathe, let's say for example there's a lathe turning, and that lathe is turning, and then suddenly there's a power cut. So whoever's the electricity goes off, the motor stops and everything becomes and everything stops working. 10 minutes later, the electricity comes back on. If this was just a normal, if the motor was just working through a normal switch, potentially the motor would start running and the lathe would start running again. So with when you use a, the reason we use an online starter is they the motors can't just restart by themselves. You have to physically press them again, because let's think about it. As soon as there's a as soon as you lose electricity electricity supply to the building through a power cut, this coil will become de-energized. Therefore, under spring pressure, the retaining contacts open again, and so everything stops and nothing will work. When the power comes back on, this start button is a normally open button, so physically needs to be pressed in again to energize the coil again. So that's why we'd use a direct online starter on a motor coil. That's the main reason. It's also to do with there's only small amounts of electricity going through the coil that can energize this to bring the contacts in. So a small circuit can operate a large circuit. So you could have 10 amps flowing through here and only sort of like a few milliamps going through here. So a small circuit can control a much larger circuit. That's useful to know when you are having, and that's going to be in the next video, when we are wiring in remote stop start. So if you've got other circuits going around the building, then you don't have to have very large cables. You can have very small cables through the control circuit, because those small cables are only going to be carrying milliamps rather than the full load current. So the full load current is only going through here. It's not going through the control circuit. A couple of things to note. These can also be wired up in three phase to run either a an electric motor, well, to run an electric motor, so they can be used for three phase where you wouldn't need a neutral going down to the motor. But the coils, they come with a 240 volt coil, they come with a 400 volt coil. And so that's important to remember. You don't need to know that for this video, but it is important to remember when you are actually wiring these up, you need, if it's a single phase, you do need to make sure that you've got a 240 volt coil. Even if it's three phase, you can still use a 240 volt coil. It would just mean that you need to take a neutral to the circuit as well. But that's enough now, I think, to explain the direct online starter and simply how to wire it up.